بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. فار کلاس سکس کمپیوٹر سائنس ناؤ وی آر گوئنگ ٹو ایکسپلور اندر آپشن گیون آن یور بکس پیج نمبر 20 وچ از نمبر فارمیٹنگ. ہاؤ وی کین فارمیٹ نمبرز ان مائکروسافٹ ایکسل اکارڈنگ ٹو آر ریکوائرمنٹ اینڈ ڈیپینڈنگ آن دا ٹائپ آف دا ڈیٹا. دس از بیسیکلی دا تھنگ دیٹ وی نیڈ ٹو انڈرسٹینڈ ان دس ٹاپک. آئی ایم گوئنگ ٹو take a new file of Microsoft Excel. I will take a new file. Now, I am going to apply different options of numbers. Now, you can see over here that there is a tab given over here. Basically, it's a group of the different buttons with the name of number format. This number format is very important. This is the number format that we are going to explore over here in this video. Let's suppose if we have got a number which is basically a mark for a subject, let's suppose 67 that I have typed over here in this cell. Now if I go to this option, you will see over here different options are available in order to apply different formats. In this way you can see that there is an option of general number, number with the fraction, number which is in the form of currency, accounting type, short date and long date options are there. If you are going to mention the time format is there. Percentage, if you want to mention the sign of percentage with your marks, then sign of percentage is there. If you want to present the number in the form of fraction, then it means in the form of A upon B, then this option is available, which is called fraction. Then scientific notation, if you want to mention the number in the form of 10 raised power, so this is called scientific notation. Or if you want to keep the number in the form of text, then this option will be applied. When we click on the text, the number is not dealt as a number, it becomes a text, means it will not be used in particularly in some kind of calculation. It will become normal text. For example, if I type over here 4500, this is a value which is a number. I go there and apply the option of number. This is now general number, no specific format. But if I apply this option number, then it will bring decimal places in it. 4500.00 means ke fractional value. Now it has become the fractional value and having points afterwards, which is basically showing that there is nothing after the point. 4500.00. Let's suppose if I type over here another number 56,000 and go to this option and apply currency. Currency will bring the symbol of dollar sign. Dollar sign is showing that this is an amount. It may be some kind of price. If you are showing some kind of price, so it will become the price, because the dollar sign is showing that this is an amount. But if you want to change this dollar sign with some other amount, so with some other currency, so we have to move towards the option of accounting. But there are some other options. For example, if you don't want to take a dollar symbol, we will go to more formats. And over here in accounting, you will see that different symbols are there available over here. You have to find out PKR. For example, I want to give in PKR. Other currencies are also there, pound, dollar, and other currencies are there. But I need to find out over here PKR. So I will go there and I will check and I will find out if PKR is there or not. And definitely it will be there. And we will find out the PKR and we will apply that PKR on our amount that we have mentioned over here. Just you can see OMR is also there. I'm going to select PKR. I will select PKR. Two decimal places is there that I'm going to apply two decimal places. So when I will click OK, then PKR will be mentioned with my amount that I have entered over here, 67,800.00 PKR. So the amount is now in lakh rupees. Why the 0.00 has come? Because the two decimal places, a point was marked over there. We can go over there and we can change this option. If we don't want to have the decimal places, we will reduce it to zero. then you will see that, but it has changed it up to dollar sign. We will have to take the PKR as well. We will have to take the PKR, and then we will take zero decimal places. Okay, now this is PKR 67,800.00 has been removed from here. I hope you have understood this point. Now, if some amount is there, let's suppose if I write 0.25, I want K it should be displayed in the form of fraction. Fraction means in the form of A upon B. So how can I do this job? I will select this 0.25 and I will go to the option of fraction 1 upon 2. What will it do 1 upon 2? It will convert it in the form of fraction. 0.25 is actually 1/4 part of 1. So it will convert the 0.25 into this format. Whenever we have got such kind of value, for example, if I say 0.75 is there, I will go there and I will apply the fraction. It will convert it that it is basically fourth of the third means 3/4. 3/4 will basically the value which is showing it in the form of fraction. In this way, we can apply these all options which are available over here. Now I will also give you an introduction with the increase and decrease of the fraction points. Let's suppose we have got 15.00. Now this is basically 15. I am going to apply number. Now it is 15.00. Over here you will see two buttons which are used to increase the decimal places or decrease. Now right side, on the right side, this is used to decrease the decimal places, and this is used to increase the decimal places. You can increase the decimal places. When I am clicking, the decimal places are being increased, and when I am clicking this, the decimal places are being decreased. So these are the two buttons that we used in order to increase or decrease the decimal places. One other option is there, which is basically called percentage. If you need to show the data in the form of percentage, how we can write it, you will click it and you will click on the percentage symbol. Percentage symbol is basically used to show the given number in the form of percentage. It will show you a percentage symbol with the number. So I hope you will be able to apply all these options on numbers that we have already gone through. Some other options are also there, just like date. Let's suppose if I write a date over here, 4 March 2020. This is the date. Now, if I click this date and I go to the option short date, short date will show you that this is basically March 4th. It will show you in the numbers. But if I go to the option of long date, it will show you the cell of the size is basically small. So I'm going to increase the size cell. It will show you the long date, including the day, Wednesday, March 4, 2020. So over here, you can see that what is the difference between the short date and long date. When I go to the short date option, it will show you in this format where there is a month is mentioned in the beginning, 3, then 4th is the date and 2020. If we go to the long date, it will show you the date in this format. I hope you will be able to apply all these options quite conveniently. At the end, we also explore this scientific notation. For example, if I write if I have written this number over here, basically this is a long number, 1,27,58,000. So if I click on this number and I go to the scientific notation, it will convert it in the form of 10 raised power, means 1.28 e for exponent 1.28 exponent 07 means 1.28 into 10 to the power 07. It is called basically scientific notation. So using this option, we have converted the number in a scientific notation format. In the higher levels, when you will go and you will study about the scientific notations and how they work, you will be able to understand this option more conveniently. But up to here, you have to go through all these options and you have to explore these options. You have to also explore the accounting option where we can apply different symbols of currency with the amount. This is your task. I hope all of you will be able to apply these all options quite conveniently. Thank you so much.